heaven on earth. Okay. Yes. We have a question. Brother David, you have a question?
Pastor, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Good to see you after a long time.
Yes.
Due to the present condition, what's your take, spiritual take or biblical take on vaccinations for COVID-19, please?
Okay. It's a very, very relevant question. Thanks for asking it, David. Now, when it comes to vaccination, there are some people who are afraid of it because they feel let me ask you. You're from a medical professional. So what? Why do you think people?
No, Pastor, I'm not from medical
professional. Object to vaccination. You know, for example, let me give you a little bit of background. You know, I have two children. So they went through all the vaccinations. I didn't have to bat an eyelid. Okay, right from the time, and in fact, we had a doctor who also attends the local church I'm part of, Dr. Sheila. So both of my kids have been they have not missed any single vaccination. And even the last one, which I did, I think I remember doing when they were 10 years of age, Dale and Natasha, you know, we went, in fact, the first few ones come one after the other, and then there's a gap, and then maybe from the age 3, I forget, you know. My kids are now, my daughter is 13 years of age, so I forget. And then there's a long gap, and then the last one is around when they are 10. So we have done it. So there's no question asked, there's no biblical debates. So I'm thinking, why should COVID-19 be any different? Okay, the only concern I am thinking, as I read a recent article published by the Hindu group, they interviewed the best virologist or expert in this field from working in arguably the best hospital in India, CMC, and that particular doctor, perhaps, you know, commenting about one of the vaccines available in India, said maybe we should have given the human trials should have been longer. Okay, so that's the case. If your reason why you don't want to take a vaccine is because you felt that these vaccines are hurriedly prepared, so you don't have confidence, I think you don't have to take it. I don't think any government in the planet at this point in time is forcing anybody to take any vaccine. Correct me when I'm wrong. So if you think that this vaccine is not adequately prepared and it might have some side effects, but what I don't want to see happening is people thinking that these vaccines equals to me taking the mark of the Antichrist, mm-hmm. and so on and so forth. I think the 666, the whole thing about 666 is we are missing the point. The book of Revelation 666 is the number of the Antichrist. What that means is seven is God's number, right from the God who took 7 days of creation all the way through the biblical history. Seven is God's number. And when we say 777, it means God is perfect, perfect, perfect. He's the ultimate of perfect. And when we say the Antichrist number is 666, he is the epitome of evil. So that's what it means. It's we don't have to overly worry about that number as such. Okay. Or we don't want to have to worry about a chip. For example, there are some people who are afraid of taking any injection because they feel that they will be, that some chip will go into their body and then they will carry the mark of the Antichrist. That is not how you avoid the Antichrist. You avoid Antichrist by saying no to porn, by saying no to foul language, by saying no to your irritable attitude, because these are evil things. Saying no to envy. So that is more important than getting a chip in your body, because a chip in the body is what goes in will not, Jesus himself said, will not actually, these non-moral things, okay, I'm not talking about consuming porn or consuming alcohol, those things will defile you. But a chip is nothing, you know, the worst thing that can happen when a chip goes to your body is people can track you. But if you have nothing to hide, I have nothing to hide. I have no problem with the new WhatsApp rules. I have nothing to hide. So if you have nothing to hide, let the whole world track you. In fact, it's, if you have nothing to hide, there's nothing you have to be overly worried about. Now, Signal, now we have this debate about WhatsApp versus Signal, WhatsApp versus Telegram. Right now, Signal may not track you, but after they grow as big as WhatsApp, they might track you eventually. I don't know. Okay, WhatsApp, you know, when it was bought by Facebook in 2014, I remember Zuckerberg saying, and in fact, I opened my graduation's message in Southern Asia Bible College when I finished my doctoral ministry that year. I opened with the Zuckerberg quote. After Zuckerberg bought WhatsApp, he said, nothing will change in WhatsApp. I began with that quote. But now things have changed because WhatsApp is now has so many customers and they want to commodify that. Right now, you know, other competitors may not track you, but down the line they might track you. So these things should not overly worry us or bother us. Okay, a chip or a vaccine or a app on the phone, unless we are using it for immorality. Okay, these things should not worry us. That's my viewpoint.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you very much.
Welcome, David. Yes. Anybody else has a question? What's the time now? Okay, 9:55. Okay, go ahead. Shoot.
Oh, one more question, Pastor. Last one.
Can I ask? Yeah, please.
Supposing you have 666 number in your mobile number, we go for a change in it? Is it not allowed?
Absolutely not. That's not the point of Book of Revelation. Now, Book of Revelation, you know, if you want to say that Book of Revelation is to be taken literally, all the elements of Book of Revelation has to be taken literally, then you have to agree with me that saying that Jesus is 50% lamb and 50% lion. Is that true? You think Jesus is 50% lion? He's called Lamb of God. So is he a lamb? He's called the Lion of Judah. So is he 50% lion, head like a lamb, body like a lion? No. It means that he was a lamb who willingly, the sense he sacrificed himself. Lamb was the most popular sacrifice animal in the world, in that culture, in the Jewish culture. So he sacrificed himself. He offered himself as a sacrifice for us. That is why he's the Lamb of God. That is not to be taken literally. Lion of Judah, lion is the king of the jungle. So though Jesus died, was a lamb, he's also a lion. Why? Because he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, somebody who's going to return back. And just like a king judges the subjects in his kingdom, Jesus is going to judge everyone in the world, the first man to the last man. Everyone is going to stand before Jesus and answer him. He's going to be the judge. He's going to be the ruler. So that the theological message is important. And as I just explained, 666, okay, it's a symbol of the Antichrist because all that it can mean is evil. He is evil, evil, evil. So it's not about a number. Don't be afraid of number six. Okay, don't be afraid. It is symbolic, just like seven is also symbolic. For example, we just celebrated Christmas. And in the genealogy, in Matthew chapter 1, if you read Matthew chapter 1 and 2, chapter 1, there's a phrase called, these are 14 generations between this point and this point. 14 was again a symbolic number which the Jewish people instantly connected with. Okay, 14 is 2 into 7. Okay, so they always, you know, equated 7 to things of God. And anything short of that is 6. For example, in the book of Revelation, you'll read about the number 1260. You'll read about 42 months. So what is 1260 days? That is 3.5 years. 42 months is 3.5 years. So the two witnesses will witness for 3.5 years or 42 months. What does that mean? So is it literal 42 months? I don't believe so, because what that means is, okay, the book of Revelation was written as a coded book, which the first recipients fully understood. The writer John did not want the persecutors of the church to understand. So they use code language. For example, parents use code language when they don't want to talk about things that children don't want to understand. They use code language. Daddy and mommy, parents use code language if they want to talk about something the children don't understand. So it's But that code language cannot be taken literally. The same way Book of Revelation uses code language so that the enemies of the gospel cannot understand. But the early believers understood. Those who knew the Old Testament understood. Okay, and those who knew the Gospels understood, and that because that's the last book of the New Testament. So 42 months, the two witnesses will witness. So well, what does that mean? They understood Jesus's command. You will go to witness two by two. It's there in the Gospels. And 42 months, they all know that Jesus lived a life. His earthly ministry lasted for 42 months, 3.5 years. So how should you witness? Witness like Jesus. It is a code of 42 months. Is like, be a Jesus-like witness. Rise up early in the morning and pray. When it's still dark, pray. Okay. Jesus' disciples never asked him how can he preach, but they all came to him and said, teach us to pray, because prayer was the most magnetic thing about Jesus' earthly ministry. Prayer. He was a man of prayer. So when you do ministry, do like Jesus. So do the Jesus ministry. That's the meaning of the term 42 months, or 1,260 days. So the numbers in the book of Revelation, there's one other number which says the blood ran for 1,600 stadia. So what is 1,600 stadia? Okay, that is 4 into 4 into 100. So 4 into 4, the blood that was flowing ran for 1,600 stadia. You can put it, don't worry about the unit very much. 1,600, what it means, 4 into 4 into 100. So people from all four directions, or people from different directions in the world, north, east, south, west, people from different categories, rich, poor, middle class, lower middle class, people from all categories, all direction, they are going to be judged. So that's used in the context of punishment, 1,600 stadia. In fact, I've done a message just on the numbers of Revelation. So it might, if you're interested, you can listen to that. So don't be worried about the literal number 6, because that literal number 6 or any other number in the book of Revelation has got a message which has got a connection with the rest of the Bible, where the same thing is talked about in a very clear way. All right, thank you.
Okay, I have a question around the same lines.
Yes.
What is the abomination of desolation?